You can go low. Alright, what's up guys? My name is Jason Leung and welcome to Ultimate Karate. In today's lesson, we are learning Yoko Geri Keage and Yoko Geri Kekomi. So side snap kick and side thrust kick. So if you guys are ready, let's get right into it. So in Shotokan, kicks are often taught in four initial sequences. Okay, you have the up, the out, the back, and the down. Okay, when it comes to side snap kick, Yoko Geri Keage, which is oftentimes first taught before the thrust kick. So we're gonna start off with that. Basically, the way I like to teach it to beginners and the way I even like to practice it is just being in a natural or neutral stance. Okay, if I'm in a deep front stance or deep kibodachi horse stance, I have to worry about the position of my stance. Okay, if I'm in a natural or neutral stance, I can focus more on the technique of the kick. So starting off with my left leg, I'm going to chamber up. Okay, now some styles, they like to touch their leg, but I don't see that's practical for real combat. So if someone's coming to me, I'm gonna touch my leg and kick, touch back and down. To me, that kind of defeats the point of self-defense. So all I like to do is just chamber up and point my knee out to the side. Okay, not to the front. You don't have to go directly to the side. Just having the intention of raising your knee up to the side is fine. Okay, and your foot is drawn in with the flat of your foot pointed to the side. Okay, you don't wanna lift it with the flat of your foot, the bottom pointed down. Okay, from here, I'm gonna kick to my left, so I'm gonna wind up, itch. Now from here, knee, second move. This is up, we're gonna go for the extension. You're gonna use your glute muscle for this. Okay, so to do that, I'm gonna lift up and strike with the blade of my foot. So if I'm here, itch, knee. Now from here, easy part is coming back down, san, and then shi. Okay, you put that together. Okay, easier said than done. Easier said than done. So you can practice to the side, or you can even practice going to the front. Okay, to the side. Right side. Front. Now, you definitely don't want to swing your leg to the side, which is like mowashigeri. Okay, that's a roundhouse kick. Your leg is going to come up in a straight line and go down in a straight line. So if you see me from the front, like so. Like so. So, not like this, okay? So, Yoko Geri, I'd say it requires the most dexterity and technique out of all the kicks because it's not really a natural movement. And in my opinion, this is more used for spur of the moment. Like if you don't have much time to react or wind up, it's just like a kick to the side. Someone's coming to me, just, it's like a little jab, a little back fist, a little back fist. Get away like that. Boom. Okay, so that is Yoko Geri Keage, side snap kick. So moving on to side thrust kick, you're gonna do, again, four initial phases, up, out, back, and down, up, extension, retraction, and repositioning your stance. So again, we can practice this just in a natural, neutral stance. Okay, the wind up is very similar to the snap. Okay, we just bring our knee up with the intention of kicking to the side. So the bottom of my foot is facing to the side, not down. Okay, my knee is pointed kind of at a 45 degree angle, not totally to the side or not totally to the front. Okay, so I'm here, my eyes are already finding my target. Now from here, you're going to pivot your supporting leg and at the same time extend your body and your leg, kicking with your heel. Just from here, itch, ni, san, and shi. Down. Okay, again. Ready? Ich, ni, san, shi, and down. Okay, so it's a lot harder than it looks, a lot easier said than done. My left leg was getting a little fatigued. We're gonna move on to the right leg. So if we're here, go ich, ni, san, and shi. So the key indicator of a strong kick is having a great, like a snappy impact sound. And you can get that feedback from how it sounds. So if you listen to your own technique, okay, listen to your technique. Okay, what I like to do is visualize like an object in front of me. I like to visualize a door or a wall. Now, if I do a kick that lacks in technique, I'm gonna hurt myself and I will not be able to break through the wall. So if I see a wall in front of me, and then that's how I do to nail my technique. I want to visualize an object, a target, a strong surface that I must kick through. Now, if you want to take your technique to the next level and you just want a drill to practice, one of my favorite drills that I came up personally and that I just always do, I incorporate this as a warm-up and just, you know, always in my toolbox of skills that I practice. And it draws actually from kata, okay? You're basically gonna be doing a side snap kick followed by backhand. Now it's up to you whether you wanna land in enpi uchi, elbow strike, or if you wanna land with a reverse punch. It's really up to you, but it teaches solid fundamentals, like how to land in a good position to strike. Okay, you definitely don't wanna do a kick and land in some funky position where you're not in a, in alignment to deliver a strike or counter or react or defend. So this drill kind of brings everything together, ties everything together in karate. Starting off with side snap kick, we're gonna go left side. I'm just gonna have my hands in a chamber position here. Okay, where you wanna start with your stance is up to you. You can go natural or one leg back. I'm just gonna go one leg back so I get that full kind of a torque with my hip flexors right here. Okay, from here, looking to my left, side snap kick in enpi uchi. So I land in zenkutsudachi. Okay, ich, ni. All right, and I can do this to the front as well. So not only to the side, but to the front. Okay, wind up. Breathe, compression, ich, and yin, ni. One more. Hey! Okay, and other side, same thing. So I'm gonna go right leg, ich, okay, wind up, ni, wind up, san. Again, one more. Okay, that's Yoko Geri Keage, side snap kick with the follow through, teaching fundamentals. So applying that same concept from that drill going into enpi uchi, you can do the same thing with a Yoko Geri Kekomi, your side thrust kick. So again, I'm gonna wind up, stay in my chambered position. Okay. I'm gonna extend, kind of pop my backhand, same time thrust with my side snap kick. Ready, ich. Okay, when you do this, try not to dip all the way back. Okay, you wanna, pull back to some extent, but just enough so that it's optimal that you are driving at the heel, okay? I don't get as much power if I'm upright here. Okay, I want to be able to stretch my technique. Stretch my technique. Okay, from here. Okay, hand position can be up to you. I obviously did some sort of a haito open hand. You can go backhand as well. So if I'm here, okay, side thrust kick, yoko geri kekomi. And you can play around with the levels. You can go low, okay? You can go low, go middle, and go a little higher, higher. All right, guys, yoko geri keage, yoko geri kekomi. You know, this is something you learn as a blue belt, green belt, and you don't stop practicing it ever in karate. So you have a lifetime to polish your technique. Don't be discouraged if you don't get this down on the first day, first month, first year. All right, this is a lifetime of training and a lifetime skill you can polish. So yeah, try those techniques out. Try it out, those tips and drills I showed you. Let me know how it goes. And I'll see you guys in the next video, okay? Thank you very much for watching. This is Jason Leung, signing in, signing out. Oss.